Welcome to Doggo.jl, your home for wholesome Julia tutorials. Pluto is a browser-based, reactive notebook programming environment created for Julia. Not only is it a powerful tool, but it's also a lot of fun to use. This video is not intended to be a comprehensive tutorial on how to use Pluto, since that's a very large subject. In fact, I have three other videos on this channel that covers how to use Pluto in more detail. But by the end of this video, you'll know how to install Pluto onto your computer, and you'll know how to get started. To install Pluto, don't open up VS Code. Instead, launch the Julia REPL. In the Julia REPL, enter the package manager by hitting the closing square bracket. In the package manager, type in add Pluto. After Pluto has loaded, exit the package manager by hitting backspace. Exit the REPL by hitting Ctrl-D. Relaunch the Julia REPL. In the REPL, type in import Pluto. Then type in pluto.run. Be sure to include the parentheses. The default web browser on your computer will open up to a welcome page. Don't close the Julia REPL. Let it continue to run in the background. On the welcome page, you'll find several very helpful notebooks that will provide you with a great introduction to Pluto. I'll let you go through these notebooks at your leisure. In the latest version of Pluto, there are also some advanced notebooks for you to explore later on, when you get more comfortable using Julia and using Pluto. For today, go back up to the top of the page and click on the button to create a new notebook. Since this is just a web browser page, you can use the same key bindings to adjust the browser window. You can maximize the browser window by hitting F11. You can use Ctrl plus or Ctrl minus to increase or decrease the magnification. In the blank cell, type in the Julia code for Hello World. In Pluto, there are three different ways that you can evaluate code in a cell. If you prefer to point and click, you can use this Run Cell Arrow button in the lower right corner of the cell. You should see Hello World displayed below the cell. To add a new cell, click on the plus button in the lower left corner of the cell. You need to hover over the corner to make the button visible. To delete a cell, click on this button at the right of the cell and choose Delete Cell. You need to hover over the button to reveal it. Add a new cell again and copy and paste the code from above using Ctrl-C and Ctrl-V. If you prefer to use the keyboard, the second way to evaluate code is to use Shift-Enter. Shift-Enter does the same thing as the Run Cell Arrow button. Add a new cell and paste the Hello World code again. Adding a new cell manually every time can get tedious, so there's a third way to evaluate code in Pluto. This time, hit Ctrl-Enter. Ctrl-Enter evaluates the cell, and then gives you a new blank cell.
Brilliant!
For the most part, I use Ctrl-Enter when I'm using Pluto. Before going any further, save this file by going up to the header and clicking in the Save Notebook bar. You can save your file anywhere, and you can name it whatever you like, but be sure to save it with a .jl file extension. Once you hit Enter or click on the Choose button, Pluto will autosave this file anytime you make a change to it. Next, let's take a look at a Julia comment. I used Ctrl-Enter here, but there's no output. Although you use the println function and comments frequently in VS Code, these are not the best ways to provide documentation inside of a notebook environment. Instead, a better way is to use Markdown. To use Markdown, begin the cell using MD, immediately followed by a pair of double quotes. Anything inside of the quotation marks will be displayed as Markdown text. To generate a header, start the quote with a hashtag character. One hashtag is the largest header size, and six hashtags is the smallest header size. The difference between Markdown and a comment is that with Markdown, you can hide the cells containing the code, and the Markdown text will still appear. You can hide cells in Pluto by clicking on the icon to the left of the cell that looks like an eye. You have to hover over the icon to make it visible. Note that the comment is no longer visible. You can make a cell visible again by clicking on the visibility icon again. Next, let's take a look at an example of reactivity. In an earlier chapter, using VS Code, when you mutated the value of x from 1 to 2, the value assigned to z did not mutate automatically. Let's see what happens when you mutate the value of x in Pluto. To mutate the value of x, I'm using Shift-Enter so I don't get a new cell. Notice that the value of z updated automatically. This can be very powerful, but this power comes with some constraints. Because Pluto is a reactive environment, variables can only be declared and assigned in one cell. In this notebook, you can't have another cell where x equals 10 or y equals 20. If you want to mutate the value of a variable, you have to do it in the original cell. This may seem a bit restrictive, but these constraints allow you to use widgets to make your experience more interactive. The Pluto widgets can be found in the Pluto UI package. Pluto has a built-in Julia package manager, so you don't need to worry about file management when using packages inside of Pluto. This code will declare a variable named lowercase letter a and bind a slider widget to it. The slider will have a range from 1 to 10 inclusive, with a step size of 0.1. This optional keyword argument will display the current value assigned to the variable named lowercase letter a. You can use the same code to bind a slider widget to a variable named lowercase letter b. Now, you can use these values for more calculations. When you move these sliders, the value assigned to the variable named lowercase letter c will mutate automatically. You can also move these cells up or down without impacting the calculations. To move a cell, drag and drop the space to the left of the cell.
Wow!
In addition to standard markdown, you can also display LaTeX, also known as math mode, by including LaTeX inside a pair of dollar sign characters within the markdown quotation marks. You've seen this function before, but here's how to generate the LaTeX version of it. LaTeX is just typesetting, so this function doesn't actually work. LaTeX is a very large subject on its own, so I won't be covering it anymore in this video, but this will give you an idea of how it's used in Pluto. You can also use other external packages in Pluto. Here's how the plots package works inside of Pluto. Depending on your computer and on your internet connection, it may take a few minutes for the plots package to load. After it's done loading, declare and define a version of the LaTeX function that will work in Julia. And then, plot this function. When you're done with your session, you don't need to worry about saving your file, since it's auto-saved for you. But you do have several other options for exporting your file if you're interested. If you click on this export icon at the very top right corner, you'll see several different ways to export your file. I use the static HTML version a lot. The static version is not interactive, so when you move these sliders, they don't mutate any values. But the file does contain all of your code and all of your plots, and you don't need to wait for any of the packages to load. Back in the live version of your Pluto notebook, close out of these export options by clicking on this X. To close out of Pluto, you can just X out of it. To close out of the Pluto session in the Julia REPL, click Ctrl-C, and then exit the Julia REPL by using the exit function or by using Ctrl-D. The next time you want to access your notebook, go back into the Julia REPL and type in import Pluto, and then pluto.run. At the welcome page, you can open up your notebook file with a .jl file extension by using the Open a Notebook bar. In the latest version of Pluto, your notebook will open up in Safe Preview mode. In Safe Preview mode, you can view the raw code, but the code will not be evaluated. To evaluate all of the code in this notebook, click on the Run Notebook Code button. After clicking that button, Pluto will evaluate all of the code in the notebook, including loading any external packages. Once it's done running, you should have your old notebook back just like you left it. So that was a whirlwind tour of Pluto. But this wasn't meant to be an exhaustive Pluto tutorial, just a little glimpse to give you a feel for what Pluto's all about. So in addition to VS Code, you now have another programming environment to add to your ever-expanding Julia toolkit. In the next chapter, you'll learn how to update to the latest version of Julia.